Lights Out. There are some who might laugh at Waldo Bryan. He feels that one day the wrath of the meek will conquer the strength of the mighty. Does that amuse you? Well, I wouldn't laugh just yet. Lights out.
Who did these?
A fellow named Caldwell.
Oh, they won't do.
Oh, but Mr. Martin, Caldwell is the best in the business.
I said they won't do. Look at that. Do you call that an interesting bird picture? And who is this Caldwell? And why did you assign the job to him? I told you to get Waldo Bryan.
Well, I couldn't get Bryan. He isn't available.
Oh, now, I don't want any excuses. He's the best there is. When Waldo Bryan does a pick the bird, you think it's going to fly right off the paper. You can almost hear it sing.
I know, sir. He's terrific. He likes birds. He knows a great deal about them, but he wouldn't take the job.
Now, why not? Waldo and I are old friends. Did you tell him it was for me? Did you tell him this is a million-dollar advertising campaign?
I did. And that's why he turned the job down. He says he's not doing commercial art anymore. He's moved out into the country and refuses to come to town. I called him several times. I even talked to his wife.
Oh, you talked to Adele, huh? What did she have to say?
Well, she's all for it. She tried to get him down here, but he wouldn't budge. Beg your pardon?
No, nothing. I was just thinking. You know, Adele doesn't belong in the country. You wouldn't put a cat in a canary's cage, would you?
Those drawings should be in the mail this afternoon.
I don't feel like doing any more work today.
Oh, Walter, you make little enough to keep wasting your time mourning over a lost canary.
I can't understand how it got away.
I'm going to the village later, and if you finish the drawings, I'll take them to the post office.
Adele, did you see it this morning? Maybe when you fed it, you left the door open.
No, I never feed your bird.
Couldn't have gotten out by itself.
Now, what are you getting at? I've been waiting for you to say that all morning.
Nothing. I'm sorry.
Will you finish the drawings?
Oh, I'm going to go out again, take a look around.
But what about the drawings?
The canary will die of exposure, and I can't do any work when I feel this way. Adele, why do you keep talking about money all the time? We have enough.
Enough for what? To keep alive and face another dull day.
For heaven's sakes, Adele, why do you keep harping on that? I'm doing the best I can.
That's not true. When you were in New York, you had more work than you could handle. We never had to worry about money then.
Well, don't you understand? I don't want to do any more commercial work.
And why not? Is the $1 million advertising campaign beneath your talent?
Oh, no. I draw birds because I like them, because I understand them. And I have to do them the way I see them, not through someone else's eyes. Honey, you understand that, don't you?
Wish I could express myself as eloquently as you do.
Oh, Waldo.
Oh, hello, Mr. Hansen.
Who are you talking to? Birds again? And doggone if they don't seem to understand you.
Maybe they do.
Well, it wouldn't surprise me then if they did. You're always a little one for making friends with them. Now, even when you were a baby, your mother used to put you out here on the lawn, and first thing you knew, there'd be dozens of them flying all around you, singing and carrying on like it was a holiday.
Yes, I remember. Oh, I've missed this place. I'm glad I'm back here.
I never have this many over at my place. Funny, ain't it? Got trees, flowers, you can put in a bird bath. I never have this many.
I guess they like it here.
Oh, it's you they like, Waldo. I don't get it. I should think they'd shun this place with that cat you got.
Adele enjoys having it around.
Well, I've got nothing against cats, but that one of yours is the meanest animal I've ever seen. He's just always hungry for birds.
Oh, cats don't hunt birds for food, Mr. Hansen. They've got to be very hungry to eat one. It's more of a kind of a sport for them.
Well, it seems like mighty poor sport to me. I guess maybe Mother Nature knows what she's up to, huh? Listen to that. I wonder what's going on.
I don't know.
I suppose they're scrapping amongst themselves, do
you? No, it's not that.
Funny.
Yeah? It's almost as if they were angry.
Now, look, son.
Now, listen to them.
Huh?
Listen to them. Where's the cat?
Outside.
When did you let it out?
2 minutes ago.
You let the cat out without this collar? You promised you wouldn't. You promised.
Well, it makes him uncomfortable.
Well, it's the only way they're safe. If they hear the bells, then the cat can't sneak up on them. You promised it, Dad. You promised it.
Hello, son.
Cat's out without his collar, Mr. Hat. Help me find it, will you?
Sure, son, sure. Take it easy. It'll be okay. What's the matter with you, Walter? Maybe you're acting kind of funny. All this business about the birds being angry and all that?
They are. Something terribly wrong, Mr. Hansen. Something's wrong. I know it.
How do you know it? Just because they're making a ruckus, that doesn't mean anything.
It does. I don't know how to explain it, but they're trying to tell me something. How do you think I knew about the cat being out?
Oh, I don't know. Hunch, I guess. We were talking about
cats.
But
this isn't the first time it's happened. A couple of times before this, I know.
Oh, now, look. You aren't going to tell me you understand that chatter?
No, not the chatter. The feeling. I understand how they feel. You don't believe me, do you, Mr. Hansen?
Well, I don't want to come straight out and say anything.
You
like
yourself
that.
Said that the birds like me. Is it so strange then that I should understand how they feel?
Where are you going? What is it?
What do you got? Oh.
It's a canary, isn't it? Wings broken. Hasn't been dead very long. Sorry, son.
Is this how you get back at me?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Is this why you let the cat loose? Adele, I love you. Why do you do these things?
Don't you know? Because you're spineless. Because you could have a lot and you're satisfied with little. Because you have the heart of a bird.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I do have the heart of a bird. But remember, birds can be made angry, too. Listen to me, Bella, listen. They're angry now. You don't know what's going on out there, but I do.
Is all this on the level?
Of course it is. Why would I lie to you?
Funny gal, Estelle. Adele, hard to figure. Well, what are you going to do?
I don't know.
I think you better come back to town.
Oh, I couldn't leave here.
Now, it's simple, Waldo. You've got to make a choice. Stay here and lose Adele or come back to town and...
I'm going to lose her anyway. She hates me. I know she does.
Oh, you know Adele. She's... She's sort of like the wick in this cigarette lighter. Soggy with combustion. Flick the little wheel and you've got a fire. One minute she hates you, the next she loves you.
If only I could be sure that she did. Well, I wouldn't mind leaving here. But if Adele doesn't care for me and I have to leave here too, I'd have nothing.
Well, it seems to me that's the chance you have to take. You've got to consider her too. After all, you were a big shot illustrator when she married you. You know, Adele isn't... Well, Adele doesn't belong in the country. She's a city creature. It's being out here, away from people, that brings out the worst in her. Oh, now look, why don't you come back to New York? It'll settle all your problems.
If she'd only do one little thing that... What did you mean when you talked about Adele marrying me because I was a big shot illustrator?
Nothing. I was just stating a fact, and you've got to consider it.
Tell me the truth, Henry. You think that's the only reason why she married me?
Oh, Waldo, I don't know.
Then I've got to find out. And I won't leave here until I do. That's funny. Birds have stopped singing. Funny that they should stop.
Waldo, you've got birds on the brain. Well, Waldo, you think it over. And remember, I'd still like you to do that job for me.
It's up to Adele. I'll let you know.
Well, I've got to get back to town. Well, so long, fella. Good luck.
Bye.
Funny how they just stopped, ain't it?
Yes.
Still there in the trees, but they stopped singing. And it gives a man a queer feeling. Like something's gonna happen. Calm before a storm.
It's exactly the way I feel. I know it.
And it's never too late to learn a lesson. Many times in my life, I've laughed at that stuff about the meek inheriting the earth.
Oh, excuse me, Mr. Hansen, that's my wife.
Has AJ gone?
Yes.
The walk did you good. Your cheeks are pink.
Oh, I'm sorry for what happened. I didn't mean what I said. I know you didn't either.
What did AJ have to say?
He wants me to come back to town.
And?
Adele, let me explain.
Explain what? That you care more for your birds than you do for me? Well, I'm through, Wall.
It's just a little thing, and
I
want
you to... Drop it, I say. Come on, let go of it. Here, drop it.
What's the matter, Captain?
It's the cat. He's got hold of the blue chip.
It did. Where'd he go?
Under the porch.
Get out of here. Come on, get out of there.
No hurry to kill it either. He's just having a good time holding his teeth and listening to it squeal. Come on out of here. Come on. I'll get my rake. Maybe we can poke.
Yes.
Okay. Listen. Come on. Get out of there. Get out of there. Hey, come on. Stop it. Adele. Come on. Too short. I can't. Come on. Adele.
Come on.
Adele.
Come on. Tell your cat. It'll come out if you call. Come
on. Come on, Johnny. Come on.
Adele, you've got to get your can out of there. You've got to call it.
He won't come out. You frightened him.
But you can try. Please, honey, please.
No, why should I? You've never done anything for me.
What kind of twisted reasoning is that? This has nothing to do with you and me. It's that bird. How can you stand to listen to it suffer?
I can stand to listen to it because I know you can.
Adele, help me. I'll do anything. Things will be all right between us, but help me.
No.
Can't get it out. What are we going to do?
I don't know.
I've got a gun over at my place. I'll go get it.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare harm my cat, you middling old fool.
You're just going to stand here and listen to that bird squeal itself out? Seems to me that Mother Nature gave us humans common sense so that we could help her out once in a while.
Well, I'm glad that's over.
Yes. It's over. I hope you never forget the sound of that bird squealing itself to death.
I'll forget it. That and a lot of other things.
Maybe you will, but they won't. Birds will remember.
You can send my trunk on to me.
I know how they feel.
Waldo, please help me to get away from here.
Wouldn't do any good. It'll always be the same no matter where you go. Funny, isn't it? You've always hated this place. Now you'll never be able to leave it.
Waldo, please forgive me. Forgive me. I'll do anything. You say anything, I will.
Don't ask me to forgive you. I've got nothing against you. It's them. Remember what you once said? You don't approve of keeping living things in a cage. Well, maybe they don't approve of living things acting the way you do.
Oh.
Yes. Now they've got you in a cage. Cage of your own making. And you'll never get out. Never.
Now, she knows it isn't very pleasant to be hated, even if it's only by the gentlest of dumb creatures. On second thought, are they so dumb? NBC Television.
Yes. So, I hope you never forget the sound of that bird squealing itself to death.
I'll forget it. That and a lot of other things.
Maybe you will, but they won't. Birds will remember.
You can send my trunk on to me. I know how they feel. Walter, please help me get away from here.
Wouldn't do any good. It'll always be the same no matter where you go. Funny, isn't it? You've always hated this place. Now you'll never be able to leave it.
Walter, please. Please forgive me. Forgive me. I'll do anything. You say anything, I will.
Don't ask me to forgive you. I've got nothing against you. It's them. Remember what you once said? You don't approve of keeping living things in a cage. Or maybe they don't approve of living things acting the way you do.
Oh.
Yes. Now they've got you in a cage. Cage of your own making. And you'll never get out. Never.
Oh.
Caldwell is the best in the business.
I said they won't do. Look at that. Do you call that an interesting bird picture?
And who is this Caldwell? And why did you assign the job to him? I told you to get Waldo Bryan.
Well, I couldn't get Bryan. He isn't available.
Oh, now, I don't want any excuses. He's the best there is. When Waldo Bryan does a pick the bird, you think it's going to fly right off the paper. You can almost hear it sing.
I know, sir. He's terrific. He likes birds. He knows a great deal about them, but he wouldn't take the job.
Now, why not? Walter and I are old friends. Did you tell him it was for me? Did you tell him this is a $1 million advertising campaign?
I did. And that's why he turned the job down. He says he's not doing commercial art anymore. He's moved out into the country and refuses to come to town. I called him several times. I even talked to his wife.
Oh, you talked to Adele, huh? What did she have to say?
Well, she's all for it. She tried to get him down here, but he wouldn't budge. Beg your pardon?
No, nothing. I was just thinking. You know, Adele doesn't belong in the country. You wouldn't put a cat in a canary's cage, would you?
Those drawings should be in the mail this afternoon.
I don't feel like doing any more work today.
Oh, Walter, you make little enough to keep wasting your time mourning over a lost canary.
I can't understand how it got away.
I'm going to the village later, and if you finish the drawings, I'll take them to the post office.
Adele, did you see it this morning? Maybe when you fed it, you left the door open.
Oh, no, I never feed your bird.
Couldn't have gotten out by itself.
Now, what are you getting at? I've been waiting for you to say that all morning.
Nothing. I'm sorry.
Will you finish the drawing?
Oh, I'm going to go out again, take a look around.
But what about the drawing?
The canary will die of exposure, and I can't do any work when I feel this way. Adele, why do you keep talking about money all the time? We have enough.
Enough for what? To keep alive and face another dull day?
For heaven's sakes, Adele, why do you keep harping on that? I'm doing the best I can.
That's not true. When you were in New York, you had more work than you could handle. We never had to worry about money then.
Well, don't you understand? I don't want to do any more commercial work.
And why not? Is a $1 million advertising campaign beneath your talent?
Oh. A canary, isn't it? Wings broken. Hasn't been dead very long. Sorry, son. Is this how you get back at me?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Is this why you let the cat loose? Adele, I love you. Why do you do these things?
Don't you know? Because you're spineless. Because you could have a lot and you're satisfied with little. Because you have the heart of a bird.
Maybe you're right. Maybe I do have the heart of a bird. But remember, birds can be made angry, too. Listen to me, Doug. Listen. They're angry now. You don't know what's going on out there, but I do.
Is all this on the level?
Of course it is. Why would I lie to you?
Funny gal, Estelle. Adele, hard to figure. Well, what are you going to do?
I don't know.
I think you better come back to town.
Oh, I couldn't leave here.
Now, it's simple, Waldo. You've got to make a choice. Stay here and lose Adele or come back to town and...
I'm going to lose her anyway. She hates me. I know she does.
Oh, you know Adele. She's... She's sort of like the wick in this cigarette lighter. Soggy with combustion. Flick the little wheel and you've got a fire. One minute she hates you, the next she loves you.
If only I could be sure that she did. Well, I wouldn't mind leaving here. But if Adele doesn't care for me and I have to leave here too, I'd have nothing.
Well, it seems to me that's the chance you have to take. You've got to consider her, too. After all, you are a big-shot illustrator.
Trees, flowers, you can put in a bird bath. I never have this money.
I guess they like it here.
No, it's you they like, Waldo. I don't get it. I should think they'd shun this place with that cat you got.
Adele enjoys having it around.
Well, I've got nothing against cats, but... That one of yours is the meanest animal I've ever seen. He's just always hungry for birds.
Oh, cats don't hunt birds for food, Mr. Hansen. They've got to be very hungry to eat one. It's more of a kind of a sport for them.
Well, it seems like mighty poor sport to me. I guess maybe Mother Nature knows what she's up to, huh? Listen to that. I wonder what's going on.
I don't know.
I suppose they're scrapping amongst themselves, eh?
No, no. It's not that. Funny.
Huh?
It's almost as... Almost as if they were angry.
Now, look, son.
Now, listen to them.
Huh?
Listen to them. Where's the cat?
Outside.
When did you let it out?
A few minutes ago.
You let the cat out without this collar? You promised you wouldn't. You promised.
Well, it makes them uncomfortable.
Well, it's the only way they're safe. If they hear the bells, then the cat can't sneak up on them. You promised it, Dad. You promised it.
Son.
Cat's out without its collar, Mr. Hat. Help me find it, will you?
Sure, son, sure. Take it easy. It'll be okay. What's the matter with you, Walter? Well, you're acting kind of funny. All this business about the birds being angry and all that?
They are. Something terribly wrong, Mr. Hansen. Something's wrong. I know it.
How do you know it? Just because they're making a ruckus, that doesn't mean anything.
It does. I don't know how to explain it, but they're trying to tell me something.
They're more of a kind of a sport for them.
Well, it seems like mighty poor sport to me. I guess maybe Mother Nature knows what she's up to, huh? Listen to that. I wonder what's going on.
I don't know.
I suppose they're scrapping amongst themselves, eh?
No, no. It's not that. Funny.
Huh?
It's almost as if they were angry.
Now, look, son.
Now, listen to me.
Huh?
Listen to me.
Where's the cat?
Outside.
When did you let it out?
A few minutes ago.
let the cat out without this collar? You promised you wouldn't. You promised.
Well, it makes him uncomfortable.
Well, it's the only way they're safe. If they hear the bells, then the cat can't sneak up on them. You promised it, Dad. You promised it.
Now, son.
Cat's out without his collar, Mr. Hand. Help me find it, will you?
Sure, son. Sure.
Can't find it.
Don't take it easy. It'll be okay. What's the matter with you, Walter? Well, you're acting kind of funny. All this business about the birds being angry and all that?
They are. Something terribly wrong, Mr. Hansen. Something's wrong, I know it.
How do you know it? Just because they're making a ruckus, that doesn't mean anything.
It does. I don't know how to explain it, but they're trying to tell me something. How do you think I knew about the cat being out?
Oh, I don't know. Hunch, I guess. We were talking about
this
cats.
Isn't the first time it's happened. A couple of times before this, I know.
Now, look. You aren't going to tell me you understand that chatter?
No, not the chatter. The feeling. I understand how they feel. You don't believe me, do you, Mr. Hansen?
Well, I don't want to come straight out and say
it. You yourself said that the birds like me. Is it so strange then that I should understand how they feel?